Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I am discussing about forensic medicine and its relevance in the society, how we can apply the knowledge of forensic medicine, how is it practically useful to us, right? So we're discussing the role of forensic medicine, and it can be useful to prove cases where there is violation of human rights, like in case of torture. Or I'll give you a beautiful example. Let's say there's a criminal case where there is a police firing which is involved, and let's say that people got wounded as a result of the police firing, and they were hospitalized, right? What would happen to them? There can be one of two things which can happen. So they can recover, right? And they could be transferred to a detention center. Now, what is a detention center? It's a place where people who are accused of doing a crime are kept. It's like basically police custody, right? They would be in police custody until there's a trial where it can be proven that they are either guilty or innocent of a crime for which they're accused, right? Now, or the other thing could be is that there could be a deterioration in their health, right? And unfortunately, if they die in police custody, that would result to, there would be a certain interrogation, which is, there would be investigation of that matter. And if it is proven that it is a case of severe medical neglect, then there is a ground where the victim's family becomes liable to receive compensation from the state. Now, this is just a case which I have given where we can apply forensic medicine and its knowledge to aid in the administration of justice, right? And it is also useful to interpret different forms of evidence. Now, what is evidence? Evidence is basically proof, right? So now that evidence can be documentary, it can be a piece of paper, or it could be verbal or oral, right? Or it could be circumstantial to aid in the administration of justice. Now, to check the relevancy of the statement which is made by a witness. Now, how relevant or how accurate is a statement which is made by a witness? Who's a witness? A witness is somebody who has perceived the crime by their senses and who can report it, or who can it is an evidence. It becomes an evidence in a court of law. To check the relevancy of the statement which is made by a witness, we require the opinion of medical officers, somebody who's a forensic pathologist. Their word becomes mandatory, because that becomes necessary to provide clarity in cases where there could be conflicting statements made by the witness, who's basically summoned by a public prosecutor. Who's a public prosecutor? Somebody who's appointed by the government in order to gather evidence and in order to prove that somebody who's accused of a crime has basically done it, right? To prove that they are guilty of committing the crime. That is the role of a public prosecutor. And we have the defense. So there are two parties, and there is a debate and argument going on, and finally there's a trial which runs in the court. Now, to check the relevancy of the statements which are made by a witness, the knowledge or the expertise of a forensic pathologist would be mandatory, right? It would be necessary. It would guide the court of law to achieve the justice. To differentiate the cause of unnatural death in case of suicide. Now, there are cases where suicide, right? People try to take their lives, or homicide, where somebody tries to kill some other person, or accidental death, right? So in all these cases, the knowledge of forensic medicine would be useful. Let's say, I'll give you a few examples here. Let's say there's a dead body with multiple crushed injuries, right, which is on a railway track. So at the first, there's something called prima facie evidence, which is the evidence which seems to be, but it has to be proven, right, which is actually presumed to be the truth unless it is proven otherwise, okay? And it is assumed that it is a case of accident. However, when the post-mortem examination is done, or when the autopsy is conducted, if we see that there are certain fatal stab wounds on the body, that would be an indication of homicide. So it is basically a case of homicide, which is made to look like accident. So in order to prove, or in order to administer justice, the knowledge of forensic medicine would be useful, right? Or in certain cases where a dead body may be thrown into a river to basically conceal murder, right? Now that would be proven in an autopsy. We have something called diatoms, which are found in the lungs, and that proves that the person was alive when they were thrown into the river, and as a result the death is basically due to homicide, right? So autopsy would confirm that. And we have cases where suspicious death may be there with wounds around the neck, which may reveal suicide. So the knowledge of forensic medicine would be useful to distinguish a case of unnatural death, whether it is a suicide, a homicide, or a accidental case of death. Also, identification of bodies after death. Now, this becomes very important, especially when we are talking about cases where there are just skeletal remains, right? So, in those cases, we take the DNA and we can identify the person. There are so many means or factors of identification. There could be decomposed bodies where there could be unrecognized faces. So, the knowledge of forensic medicine would be involved to identify such bodies. Or we are talking about cases where there could be electrocuted bodies or burnt bodies. Or in cases where there is mass murder, like plane crashes or earthquakes. So in all these circumstances, when identification becomes almost next to impossible, the knowledge of forensic medicine is what is applied to identify those bodies. We'll talk about what are the factors of identification later. To justify the medical practice in cases of negligence and aid in the law enforcement. Now, there are so many cases where medical negligence is involved. There are different kinds of negligence. We have civil negligence, criminal negligence, and all those kinds of negligence. So we can identify that, right? And also to justify third party insurance claims. Okay, it also plays a remarkable role in guarding the safety of each and every individual and also ensuring that anybody who's accused is not unjustly condemned. Now, according to the Indian court, anybody who's accused of doing a crime is actually they think that they are innocent unless it is proven to be otherwise. We have to look at the evidence, and only after the trial in the court is completed and the sentence is given do we know whether they are actually guilty or whether they are innocent of a crime, right? So there is an example here. A man may die of coronary thrombosis or they may die of myocardial infarction while walking on a road, and subsequently they may be run over by a vehicle, right? And the driver would be charged of culpable homicide, right? So now what happens is we apply the knowledge of forensic medicine, we conduct the histochemical and biochemical studies of the injured tissue. We look at the heart, we look at the internal examination of the heart, and then we can establish the post-mortem origin of the injuries, right? And we have to look into coronary vasculature, and if that reveals the presence of a disease, right? So we know that the cause of death is natural, right? Unlike what it looks like, it is not the homicide. Now this knowledge would be useful to give justice, right? Okay, and also there's a role of doctor in medico-legal cases. But it is very important that doctors are not dogmatic about their opinion. They should be open to receive knowledge from various sources when they give their opinion.